connection from the moment the bell rang, and these two didn't give each other a second, almost thankful to get a moment to himself after dumping Steamboat back to the floor, letting you know that Savage understood he was in a fight unlike any other he'd been in before. Things were only getting started. The Macho Man was trying everything, and that included fighting dirty. But Steamboat continued to have an answer at edge, and Savage's frustration led to him making a big one, charging at Steamboat only to be backdropped to the floor. Steamboat finally had a huge opportunity to pour on the pressure and put Savage away. Thank you. And Steamboat's counter wrestling remains the key to this match. Easily backdropped him to the floor. If Andre could shake off headbutting the ring post so quickly, what was it going to take to keep him down for a three count? Hulkamania was looking to be in deep, deep trouble. Thank you. That moment where Hogan finally takes Andre down with the clothesline and seeing Andre timbered. Rude looked to put...
Checking out the Mirage mode. Yeah, there's a bonus match at the end too, man. It's like a 30-man over the top rope battle royal. You get to pick from a list of legends, and you have to eliminate a for real, man. That's crazy. Especially the people on PC, man. I don't know what they do with their settings, but it's always wild. Yeah, it's, I think so. I think it's cross-platform, just like Community Creations. I'm not sure if they updated it for the matches or not. They might not have. I haven't really tried to play online yet. That happened to me a few times. I got counted out. Yeah, that was a cool feature.
Hogan had been out-muscled by opponents before, but they were usually 7 feet tall or 400-plus pounds. Seeing Ultimate Warrior...
Your first match in My Rise is against Dominic Mysterio.
As Warrior lifted Hogan up, things were looking perilous for the Hulkster.
Come on, get up. I'm about to remove their reverse stats, bro. I ain't got time to be doing this.
Viper continued to show glimpses of the old Hot Rod, but still tried to play by the rules.
to come in and smack you.
Razor Ramon was looking to prove that despite never defeating Shawn Michaels for the Intercontinental. Knowing Ramon now had a weak point, Michaels crashes that ladder right into the ribs of Ramon, and he has completely turned the tide of this match. You can see it on the faces of Razor's fans. Well, you can just climb it and jump off from great heights, right?
California.
Who is this referee? that Kim Shamrock?
Showed why this match was perfect for him. Instead of just punching Austin's face, he'd attack Austin's legs instead. Bret wanted to make sure that his search for revenge also ended with him victorious. Brock continued to maintain control, but Austin would not stop. No way. No way. biggest enemy for years. Kurt Angle always looked to prove that his opponent had no business in the ring with him. He used basic mat wrestling secrets. The reversals in the... As Angle maintained his control, Eddie again grew desperate, looking for any chance to get Angle on the defensive. So evenly matched, no one able to maintain a dominant position for long. both men were unsure of their path to victory. Eddie had fought so hard to get back into the match. Struggling to get Angle back to his feet, hoping to put the finishing touches on his... Shawn Michaels and Kurt Angle came into this match looking to prove their superiority over the other. Now, the match was about to kick up a notch. Angle looking to suplex Shawn Michaels right through the announce table showed how badly he wanted to injure the Heartbreak Kid in this contest. While Michaels managed to escape the attempt, and tapped out in the middle of the ring, giving Kurt Angle Undertaker rushed at Shawn, but Michaels saw it coming and managed to move. Immediately, HBK would focus on the injured knee, knowing that the best way to beat a big man is to take away the vertical base. The second it seemed Undertaker was getting back up, Shawn floored him with a huge low bridge enziguri to stay in control. Shawn would the win. Michaels would give himself a big opportunity when his Now Undertaker was in full control. With HBK down on the mat, Undertaker would pull the straps down. Undertaker was hoping to squash Shawn in the corner, sensing that Michaels was nearly finished. But pure instinct allowed Michaels to get his boot up. It was over, even after the F5. Struggled early to take command of the match, mirroring the struggle. Thank you. had squandered his advantage in the match. to stop Seth Rollins in his tracks.
California, City of Angels.
That up with yet another F5. It looked like Rollins had crashed the party, but he wasn't looking to stay long. Reserves, Reigns would fall victim to Seth Rollins. Now, as we all know, a triple threat match is every superstar for themselves. But despite not being friendly with each other, Charlotte and Becky realized that it might be best for them to focus their efforts on Ronda. Looking for a double powerbomb, Ronda would manage to reverse, putting Charlotte in an armbar. Eventually, Rousey found her momentum again and managed the jaw-dropping feat of placing both Becky and Charlotte into arm bars. Realizing that they were better together, Charlotte and Becky would turn the tide on Ronda. Muscling her up and hitting her with a series of double-team power bombs. Reversing into a crucifix pin, she was Stone Cold said he was coming to open one last can of whoop-ass on KO, and he wasted no time delivering on that promise. As he had numerous times in his legendary career, Austin was able to hurt Owens again, regaining command of the fight. With KO dazed, Austin threw him onto the announce table. Remember, Owens had tried and failed to use a table earlier, so now Austin wanted a turn. Austin's plan here was very clear. He was going to beat the hell out of Owens, but he was going to make it look like it was easy. Classic Austin here, enjoying a few cold beverages while basking amongst the screaming fans and just absolutely taking catch a breather from the constant onslaught. But instead of following up with... We'll be right back. Rhea Ripley wanted to prove that a new generation was ready to take over the throne that the Queen had occupied. A rare double knockout brought the action to a halt as these two were proven to be more evenly matched than initially anticipated. But it was Charlotte who appeared to be the fresher competitor, getting to her feet first, and then nearly taking Rhea's head off with a huge running boot to the face. Ripley was now struggling to keep up with Charlotte, who saw the chance to connect with something big.
Thank you.
Despite only being made official weeks prior to WrestleMania, the entire WWE Universe was excited to see this clash between Asuka and Bianca Belair. Asuka looked to take control. Match standout was how Asuka and Belair were both so prepared for each other. Belair attempted the KOD. Asuka had grabbed the ropes to counter and pull herself free. A series of counters saw Belair duck Asuka's attempt to hit her with the poison mist. Roman would take a trip to ringside that would take his control away. After Cody slammed Roman into the mat, he'd climb to the apron. We'll be right back. Cody's adrenaline was high, and he could see that Roman was fading. Without anyone to help him, Cody would have to do this alone. One crossroads connected, but Cody was...